Welcome to a simple calculation that might surprise you. We will also take a look at a proof as to why the result is always the same. To begin, step one is to think of a counting number from 1 to 10 and write it down so you don't forget. Step two, double the number or multiply by 2. Step three, add 6 to the result. Step four, divide the result by 2. And finally, step five, subtract the number you selected in step one from the result. And now, not even knowing what counting number you started with in step one, your answer is 3. But let's take a look at why the answer is always 3. Step one was to think of a counting number from 1 to 10. Because this number is unknown, let's represent the unknown counting number using the variable x. Step two was to double the number or multiply by 2. So if we have x and multiply by 2, x times 2 is equal to 2x. Step 3 was to add 6 to the result. If we add 6 to 2x, this gives us the expression 2x plus 6. Step 4 was to divide the result by 2. If we divide the quantity 2x plus 6 by 2, we can simplify this quotient by factoring 2x plus 6. We can factor 2x plus 6 by factoring out the greatest common factor of 2 between 2x and 6. If we factor out the 2, we have 2 times the quantity x plus 3, which we can check if we distribute, we do still have 2x plus 6. But now that it's in factored form, notice here we have 2 divided by 2, which simplifies to 1, and therefore the expression simplifies to x plus 3. The quantity 2x plus 6 divided by 2 equals x plus 3. And then step 5 was to subtract a number from step 1, which in our case is represented by the variable x. So if we have the expression x plus 3, and then we subtract x, because x minus x is equal to 0, notice how the result is always 3. One more thing we might notice is that x can be any real number, and the result of these calculations will always be 3. So in step 1, we were told to select a counting number from 1 to 10, but we could also change this and select any real number, and the answer will still always be 3. Thank you for watching.